Hey guys, a few days ago I made a video showing how to detect barcode scan in React. I actually ditched the method that I used in that video in favor of this method, so I wanted to do a really quick update video. This is much cleaner, much simpler, and uses a package that already exists, and I will show you that package here in a second. So, the first thing that you have to do, I have a little application set up here, by the way. You have a state that stores the barcode scan, and then you can also set the barcode scan. And that's it. The other part of the app just displays the barcode scan. So, first thing you need to do is install the package. Now, I'll show you what happens if you try to use npm. So it's npm I use slash scan just detection. And I'll go ahead and leave a link to this in the description below, the whole npm package. It's a great package. So, just to get a resolving issue. There's a few things you can do with npm to fix that, but the easiest thing to do actually is just use yarn. So you can use yarn add use scan detection. Perfect. So this will add it. You just take a minute or two, and then while that's adding, I'll go ahead and import it here. So then you just import use scan detection. Oops, you actually don't need these brackets because it's default exported. From use slash or dash scan dash detection. Perfect, just like that. And all you gotta do is call it. It's a hook, just call it like this. Put an object in there with the options. And then inside the options, you use on complete. So on complete is a function here. And you can see this all in the docs. Also, again, link down in the description below. Let's see, actually, it feeds through code as the scanned code as a parameter to the callback function for onComplete. Now, this is one way to do it. You can use it as a parameter here and then do whatever you want with it. But React hooks allow you just to add the set hook there, and that will do this exact same thing. It'll take that parameter and set it correctly. Now, the other option I use is min length. So I like to set it to 3. That's just what I need for my particular barcode scans. Perfect. Now, whoops, if I go to Chrome, you can see no barcode scanned at the moment. Turn my barcode scanner on, scan a barcode. Oops, not in the application there. Oh, you know why? I'm not running the application. All right, you gotta start the app. Perfect. Now it should work. Come on. Scan. There it goes. Perfect. And you can see it scans it just fine. I'll do another barcode here. My barcode scanner isn't scanning great. There. Another barcode. That's it. Super simple. Way more simple than the last one. So hope that works. And thanks for watching.